Hinduism, does it last forever, or are there other places where the soul goes after heaven?
Yes, you see, this question has been asked by on the internet as well. They said, Mr. Lakhani, if you believe in law of karma, that what we sow is what we reap, then why should we be cast into heaven or hell? Because you are going to kind of pay a price of what you set into motion in the future life, reincarnation. So why should we bother with the idea of heaven and hell? In fact, that is correct. We are saying that in the Hindu tradition or in the Dharmic tradition, we don't have an eternal heaven or hell. There's no, it's an Abrahamic idea. We don't have it. Thankfully, we don't have that. This, according to me, sounds almost childish, that you go to eternal heaven and fun. It's nonsensical. Or that you get burned or kind of roasted forever and ever and without ever escaping. That's frightening. It's more like a horror story. So according to us, the Indic traditions, we say we continue our progress, spiritual progress, from one life to another life through reincarnation. So the activity we do kind of chisels our character, and that shows up in our next life. And that in a way guides us to lead our future lives. So the character you chisel in one life stays with you. That is how the law of karma catches up with you in your next life. Now, what about this heaven and hell? We don't have eternal heaven and hell. And yet we say, while you are transmigrating, when you give up one body and enter another body, that the transitory period is not sometimes immediate. It doesn't happen immediately. You kind of drift into a kind of almost like a dream-like state when you give up one body and inhabit another place, which is almost like a mental world rather than a physical world, where you inhabit that world, just like we do in dreams. Every night we dream. We create a world of our own in our mind, and we are living in it. In the same way, when you give one body, and before you are reborn in another body, you might go through this transitory situation where you create a heaven or hell, a mental world of your own, and you live in it. Suppose you're a very, very warm personality, then that world that you create for yourself will be very warm and very loving and very nice. And if you are a cantankerous person, the world that you will inhabit will automatically reflect your character. So it might be very, you know, kind of cantankerous. So these are temporary heaven and hells between lifetimes in the Hindu tradition, and they are never forever. In fact, the Hindu tradition says this heaven and hell that we talk about, this temporary heaven and hell, transitory ones, are not really good. Because in a way, this is not where you can really do and act out anything. You would be reborn in a body, in a human body, to make further spiritual progress. There you are in a way kind of drifting off in a like a daydream state. So our heaven and hell, thankfully, are not permanent at all. And yet we do believe there are other realms of existence. And there are some superior realms of existence we call Devlok. There are kind of very mundane kind of level of existence, which you call Pitri Lok, where you kind of in a way interact with the people who passed away in your family. So these are even the Devlok, we don't give a lot of emphasis. We say it's better for you to be reborn as human and progress spiritually here. This is called Karma Bhumi, a place where you act out and do actual real action to progress spiritually.